Well, the men's 400 metres coming up now, the first heat. And it's a big field. There are the records for you. There are seven heats in this 400 metres. But the first three and three fastest through to the semi-finals tomorrow. There are a couple of non-starters in this first heat. The athlete from Oman, as you will see. But there's Butrim, then Daldin. Ronnie Quow's gone. That's unfortunate for Trinidad and Tobago. He's useful. Oscar Pistorius runs in the sixth lane. Languin Santos of the Dominican Republic in seven. And then Rasheen McDonald of Jamaica in lane eight. So with the exclusion of those two, it's the job a little bit easier. Ronnie Quow would probably have featured there. But nevertheless, there is there are two stories here. The man, Oscar Pistorius, the blade runner, double amputee, who is in these championships, and he'll be well celebrated by the crowd, that's for sure. And he runs a very different race to the rest. Very steady over the first half. It's almost as if he runs two even 200 metres, so he'll always come through a little bit stronger in the second half of the race. And the other story is the world junior champion Santos, who is only 18 years old. But Pistorius is a real story. He dominates in the Paralympics, he really does, and it's great to see him given this opportunity. That's Maxim Dildin, European Team Championship winner in 2011, ran the first leg of the Russian relay, won bronze in Beijing 4 years ago, the Russian. There's Santos, and he's not even stripping down, and the world junior champion, 44.45 in that World Junior Championship. A terrific prospect. The age of 18, 44.71, then broke the Dominican Republic senior record, which had been held by Felix Sanchez, remember, the former Olympic champion in the 400 meter hurdles. But more of that in a moment. Butrim, Dildin, Pistorius, Santos, and McDonald. Heat one, the men's 400 meters. First three through to the second round or the semi-final tomorrow. Pistorius will always find himself in a little bit of difficulty in the first half of the race, but he does run even pace, I can assure you, and he should come back a little bit. But the Jamaican McDonald going very strongly, also Santos, and the two athletes on the inside, probably Dildin of Russia going the better of the two on the inside lanes. But Pistorius now should make a little bit of headway into the as they come off the final bend of the straight, but it's McDonald and Santos, these two, the world junior champion, just taking over. He's a tidy runner indeed, and here comes Pistorius. I said to you that he runs even pace races, and he does, and he's going to qualify for the semi-final, and he's done it brilliantly, hasn't he? So, Santos wins it, Pistorius in second place, easing down, with Dildin in third, the Russian, and 45.04, and really, that's so interesting to see the way Pistorius runs. At 200 metres he looks well out of it, but I can assure you he runs...
Not weedy, OK?
Not, other people don't do that. They run very different, but this man runs, or Pistorius runs even paced. It's a big point to make. 45.04 for Santos is a cool cookie, isn't he? He's only 18, mature beyond those years, certainly.
Very fine run, very controlled run. Although you're quite right on Pistorius, actually got a better start than in some of the races we've seen him. I think he will have benefited from dry conditions. Sometimes he has a bit of trouble on wet tracks. But he ran very well indeed. And indeed at 45.44, Pistorius has had a season's best there in qualifying. Dildin also in a qualifying spot. So three men at 45 and a half or better. That's pretty useful standard. And they were quite a long way clear of Rasheen McDonald of Jamaica, who started so well but faded badly in the finish. But this man is an outstanding prospect. Santos, Dominican Republic.
But there it is, Santos, Pistorius and Dildin. And 45.04, 45.44, 45.52. Pistorius, well done to him. They're the three qualifiers by right. There'll be three fastest losers coming from the seven heats, though.
Well, we now turn to the track where there's Plenty of electronic equipment, of course, to help the start and the timing and all the rest of it. There's the lineup of Heat 2, which features Kirani James, the world champion. He goes in lane 6. From Grenada, just 19 years of age still. There he is, just getting ready. First three to go through, another three on times. Eight-man field here. He's very much the top man to look out for. Arnie James, Grenada. World youth, world junior, world senior champion. Next to him, outside in fact, is Ramon Miller of Bahamas. Commonwealth and Pan American Games bronze medalist. Got good solid credentials there. The best of 44.87, making him the second quickest in the lineup, which is Alfara of Palestine, Lendor of Trinidad, Bonivaccia from Curaçao, running as an independent Olympic athlete mark, since they don't have an Olympic association. Barnaby of Canada, James of Grenada, Miller, Bahamas, Makwala, the African champion this year from Botswana, and Desta from Ethiopia. So useful field here, but there's no question of the favourite being Kirani James in 6. Heat 2 of the 400 metres.
Set.
Three of the fancied runners from Kirani James, outside him Miller and Makwala of Botswana, and certainly Miller has gone off pretty quickly. James running a fairly restrained race at the moment, and it's the Botswanan Makwala out in lane 7 who's got a particularly good start. So too Lendor of Trinidad on the inside. Kirani James just holding back a bit now. Naudo coming past the Bahamanian Miller, long striding, but out in lane 8, Makwala of Botswana has run off very hard indeed. Three to go through, still Lendor of Trinidad inside. But here comes Kirani James, just shifting up the gears a little bit, looking so easy. And it's Kirani James who wins it. A real tussle off a second. Very close indeed, with a late finish there from Miller of Bahamas, bringing him back into contention, along with Bonavaccia, the Curaçao athlete, running as an independent Olympic athlete in the greyish vest in lane 4 there. But James was so impressive, 45.23, the winning time there for the reigning world champion. Miller just doing enough to come up into second place. We think it was probably Bonavaccia. Yes, it was Bonavaccia who got third and ran a personal best of 45.60 to do so.
Well, in the final stages, you're quite right. It was a good run by the Botswanan, Makwala, who then faded pretty badly as the rest came through. But Kirani James ran this beautifully, really did. And Ramon Miller came through from Bahamas very late just to go past Bonavaccia. But they're the three qualifiers by right. But this man has got a magnificent technique. Lovely, lovely flowing run. And there's a lot of racing left in the tank on that occasion. 45.23 for Kirani James. A very, very steady first 200.
We're about to have lined up on the track E3.
Well, there is the lineup. Samford of Israel drawn in lane 2. Rosicky of Brunei in 3. Tranikin of Russia in lane 4, Stone of Papua New Guinea in 5, Borle of Belgium in 6, Maslak of the Czech Republic in lane 7, and then Zaykov of Kazakhstan in 8, and Hyatt of Jamaica in lane 9. So the favourite probably here, Jonathan Borle, the Belgian, running very well indeed, won the race in Monaco, and looked very, very good indeed in that race. There he is, Jonathan Borle. And one of the Borle twins, very, very successful this season. Height right on the outside, the Jamaican, new Jamaican champion, incidentally, he's a former police officer. Got a best of 44.83, so he should feature in this. But with the first three to go through. Right on the inside, that's Sanford of Israel, taking his time. They're going to rush him in a moment, I think. He's doing his shoelaces up and holding up the Olympic Games at the moment. relay, former Belgian record holder, replaced by his twin Kevin, incidentally. 44.74 is best this season, slightly quicker in 2010. Sanford, Rossiti, Trenikin, Stone, Bourlay, Mashlak, Zykov and Hyatt. Heat three of the first round of the 400 metres, the first three to go through by right to the semi-finals tomorrow. Certainly Bourlay has gone off very, very quickly indeed. Outside him, Mashlak of the Czech Republic has gone off pretty quickly, but Bourlay looks very, very good indeed, and so does Trenikin, the Russian, but Bourlay is running this very quickly. The Jamaican on the outside still in there, but the athlete from the Czech Republic, Mashlak, going well, but Bourlay's got this one at the moment as they approach 300, and I'm suggesting he probably hopes that he can ease down a bit right on the inside. Sanford of Israel is going quite strongly in the final stages. But Bourlay coming away with this, along with Mashlak of the Czech Republic and the Russian Trenikin on the inside. So let's see who comes through on that. Well, Bourlay gets it. Mashlak gets second place. Trenikin gets third place. So 44.43. Wow. Well, that is a personal best for Jonathan Bourlay. And the way in which it was done was quite emphatic. That was very, very impressive.
Very impressive indeed. He just regained the national record from his twin Kevin, who we'll see, of course, later in Heat 7 of this series. But very, very impressive, because he ran that time despite needing to run all out in the straight. He did keep going at a good speed. Quite a battle on behind him, too, and some excellent performances. Mashlak, the Czech athlete, has smashed his national record with 44.91, and Trenikin ran 45 seconds, the Russian, with Hyatt not so far behind in fourth place at 45.14. A very, very impressive run. Both Bourlay twins are in superb shape right now. So the Europeans really going well here with two national records from Bourlay and from Mashlak. Now here we have the lineup for Heat 4. Three big names on the inside there. Pinder of Bahamas, Henry of the US Virgin Islands, and Gonzalez of Jamaica. And of course it's good to see Bryson Nellum of the USA back in action. He was shot in a gang incident 3 years ago, and they thought he might have to give up athletics, but he's back and he's got third place in the US Championships after proving to be an outstanding youngster, still just 23 years of age. So here's the lineup for the leading contenders. This is Demetrius Pinder, the Bahamas athlete, who is second in the World Indoor Championships this year, now with a best of 44.77. Then there's Nellum, I was referring to before, but his best is pretty close to that, 44.80 he's run this year. Four men in this field who've broken 45 seconds. Personal best. There's another of them, Jermaine Gonzalez of Jamaica. Well, now he was fourth in the World Championships last year and set the Jamaican record at 44.40 2 years ago. We also have Tabari Henry for the US Virgin Islands, fourth in the World Indoor Championships, and he's a man with a best of 44.77 going in lane.
On your mark.
It's Pinder, Bahamas, Henry, US Virgin Islands, Gonzalez, Jamaica, Bravo, Venezuela, Masrahi of Saudi Arabia, Nellum of USA, Yefremov of Macedonia, and Thet of Myanmar. Heat 4. Top men are on the inside, Pinder, Henry and Gonzalez, and then further out in lane 7, Bryson Nellum, and Nellum's gone off pretty hard in the red of the USA, but those three men on the inside lanes also going well, Pinder, Henry and Gonzalez, not much to choose between them. Pinder now though making his way up, and maybe he'll just have a fractional lead at the 200 meter point. Mellon is being chased down, meanwhile, by Misrahi of Saudi Arabia, who's running strongly. Big man further out there in lane six. But it's Pinder on the inside, being tracked by Henry and Misrahi. Mellon has got a work to do. It's certainly Pinder, well clear of this field. Who will take the other spots? The answer is Mellon comes through to take second place. And then it's pretty close between Henry of the Virgin Islands and Masrahi of Saudi Arabia. And the disappointing man there was Gonzalez of Jamaica, who was out of those first five. Winning time there, 44.92, but the official time there for Pinder of Bahamas. Not so far off his personal best, and now he showed his form indoors, and he's taken that through to the outdoor season as well. Well, here he is, we're looking at a replay there. Pinder in the blue on the inside is well clear. And behind, fighting behind him, Henry of the Virgin Islands. Now look at the action on the outside. We've got Mellon coming through for the USA, passing Misrahi inside him. Gonzalez certainly is the disappointment, finishing well back in this lineup. Mellon has got second place and Misrahi just behind him. Gonzalez, who's been below par this year most of the season in any case, but again was a race where the top men came through. There's the winner, Demetrius Pinder of Bahamas.
It really was quite an impressive run, wasn't it, from the inside lane, and totally and utterly in control of that race. And it's interesting to see how different people approach the races here, but he had the inside lane. Some people enjoy that, some people enjoy the outside lanes as well, where they have to a clearer and less of a bend. This fellow clearly enjoys his position. Strong finish in the outside lane there by Mellon of the United States.
Looking at that, to Henry probably did just get it from Misrahi for third place spot. They're pretty close between them. Maybe not so much of that shot. Anyway, we'll see when the photo decides. But for all the people who are happy with the way it's gone, there are some who are not. In that category, is Gonzalez of Jamaica.
Also to the fifth heat of the 400 metres for men. The first round, Levain of Great Britain, drawn in lane two. Brown of the Bahamas, then Latis of Latvia. Lane four is empty now, there's been a withdrawal. McQuay of the United States, then Kanemaru of Japan and Stanley of Paraguay in the eighth lane. Just the first three to go through, plus the three fastest losers. So. Well, Brown has always been there or thereabouts, got a 44.95 this season, his personal best 44.40, but McQuay, the American, 44.49 this season, was second in the US trials. He's a big fella. Nigel Levain. Levain fourth in the Diamond League race in London. He's done very well, his personal best this season, 45.11. And you can see what everyone else is doing in this race, but it's going to be a tough one. But the first three to go through by Wright. McQuay, 44.49, as I say. So heat number five. Levine, Brown, Latis, McQuay, Kanemaru and Stanley. Three to go through. Well, the empty lane, actually, it's a little bit disconcerting for Brown, but he's caught it up, and it looks pretty pretty good down the back straight. Kanemaru, the Japanese, has gone off very quickly down towards 200 metres, followed by McQuay, who looks absolutely casual as he approaches, and Brown now making some headway with 200 metres to go. Kanemaru with Stanley of Paraguay right on the outside, and McQuay now making some headway. Into the home straight then. Kanemaru has run very, very well indeed. Levine on the inside comes through as well, the Great Britain. And Chris Brown. So Chris Brown and Levine with McQuay, these three. So there they are, those three as I gave it. Brown, McQuay and Levine, the three qualifiers at 45.39. And no problems there. It went pretty well with the form book, let's be honest. You have to perform in these heats, that's for sure. I just wonder, thinking about the next heat, what LaShawn Merritt must be going through his mind. Chris Brown at 45.40, the winner of the heat, but, and he'll get a seeded lane. Let's just look at this in the final stages. Kanemaru had run very, very hard. He ran it as a final. And by the time he got to 300 metres, he was struggling a little bit, and the rest came past him. Levine ran a very sensible race from the inside. And, of course, Brown and McQuay just coming past him. McQuay looking very, very easy indeed in the second 200 metres. He was casual to the first. Brown ran a fairly even 400. He always does. He looks pretty confident. He's experienced too.
Well, the first three were well clear there. Kanemaru just about held off the fourth, but his time of 46.01 nowhere near enough to advance to the semi-final. Of course, we haven't seen any time to approach that at the moment of the flying Belgium, the first of the twins, Jonathan in action, who ran 44.41. And see what his twin can do in two races at a time.
There it is, Chris Brown, Tony McQuay, Nigel Levine, the three qualifiers, 45.40 to 45.58.
Heat six of the 400 metres. There's the lineup. And it features the defending champion, LaShawn Merritt, also with a world gold and two silver medals. Came back from a drugs ban, but the question is he fit? There's Conrad Williams of Great Britain, a relay silver medalist at World and Europeans. He was second in the British Championships this year, and he has a best of 45.08. Driver all, as they can see him on the giant screens here at either end of the Olympic Stadium. There's a distinctive headband. We have Lalonde Gordon of Trinidad Tobago, the national champion, who goes in lane 5, world indoor relay silver medalist. He has a best of 45.02, slightly quicker than Williams. The big question is LaShawn Merritt fit? Recovering from that injury problem. LaShawn Merritt in top form, of course, the class runner in this field, 43.75, his personal best. That makes him the fifth fastest of all time. 44.12 this year, had five wins coming into that last Grand Prix meeting where he was, of course, a non-finisher. So the question mark on Merritt, interesting to see how he gets on. Goes in lane 3 in the sixth heat of the 400 metres. Williams, Great Britain, Merritt, USA, Hashemi of Iran, Gordon of Trinidad and Tobago, George of Guyana, Solomon, the junior from Australia, and Deke Nodge of Hungary, the European silver medalist. Outstanding youngsters on the outside here. Solomon of Australia has gone off well, and Deep Nod. Merritt, a very restrained start indeed, and there's a big question mark over him as Conrad Williams of Britain goes past. It does not look like Merritt is fit. He's going to stop, I think. He's out of it, so we've lost the defending champion. Meanwhile, who is going to qualify from this race? Gordon of Trinidad is going very well. And on the outside, Deep Nodge of Hungary. Williams is coming through on the inside for Britain as well. But it's the Trinidadian, Yolande Gordon, who's going to come through to lead here. Williams is running well. So too the 19-year-old Australian Solomon. Solomon finishing very strongly indeed on the outside here. And Solomon, the Australian, is going to win this race. Solomon wins it, Gordon in second place. And then it's just Williams ahead of Deep Nodge. And the sadness here is that, well, he gave it a go, but it just wasn't there for the defending champion, the Sean Merritt of the USA, and his hopes of retaining his Olympic title dashed there in just a few seconds when he found he really couldn't put it together when it mattered. Couldn't have been a surprise for him.
No, when we saw him in London at the Diamond League meeting in London, and he pulled up there holding a hamstring. We wondered whether it was cramp on that occasion, but he clearly is limping already, and that hamstring is not performing, and it's so sad to see this. He tried so hard in the chamber to get fit, but there just wasn't enough time for him to do it. And at the end of the day, Solomon, who really right on the outside, the yellow top Australian, really left it very late. He ran it very much as a final, but nevertheless came through along with Lalonde Gordon, the tall figure in the center, and Conrad Williams.
Well, a brilliant time for Solomon. The junior is just around 45.18, smashing his personal best of 45.42. He's put us together a series of very good times here. He's strong, and he finished very hard indeed, coming from way behind Gordon. Well, the time wasn't very quick for third, but Williams of Great Britain has got through in 46.12, just ahead of the European silver medalist Deep Nodge. So, the Sean Merritt has to make his way out, and of course he's surely not going to be fit enough to run in the relay either, so it looks like the end of his Olympic hopes. Quite a case, of course, when he came back from that drugs ban as to whether he would be allowed to run in the Olympic Games. He was given the all clear, but in the end, it's to no avail. So there's the result. Solomon, the Australian, smashing his best at 45.18. Gordon of Trinidad with 45.43, and Conrad Williams of Britain are the three who will go through to the semi-finals.
Well, there it is, the lineup for Heat 7. Borlée of Belgium, Hutchinson of Poland, Hertold of Dominica, Aruni of Great Britain, Nalgio of Benin, Bren of Costa Rica, Youssef of Sudan. But there's Martin Rooney, the Croydon Harrier from Great Britain in front of his home crowd, sixth in the Olympic final last time in 2008, 44.92 this season. He's got to get in the first three to qualify. Well, there's Borlée. When he started, he was the record holder for Belgium, but his brother has now taken that from him, and so he's a little bit to prove. So, bronze medalist in the World Championships last year, Kevin. Marchinson, that's Bren of Costa Rica, 45.20 this season, the Pan American champion last year, the World Indoor champion this year as well, Bren. A really good run there, 45.20 is outdoor time this season. Youssef of Sudan is a resident in Britain, a member of the Newham and Essex Beagles Club. Club system thriving in Great Britain. So Rooney, Great Britain, drawn in lane five. Outside him is Benin, Naligo, and then Bren, of course, as you've seen, and Youssef right on the outside. Marchinson, let's put that right, Pole is also in the race in lane three, just outside Borlée. So Borlée, Marchinson, Hertold, Rooney, Naligo, Bren and Youssef. Heat 7 of the men's 400 metres. Well, Youssef has gone off pretty quickly, and so has Bren, a second from the outside, and Rooney making some headway, and inside him Hertold of Dominica running very strongly indeed. But Bren, Borlée right on the inside as they approach 200 metres. Will come into contention as they hit the bend, and right on the outside there, Bren still going very strongly. Borlée now will chase him as the bend unwinds and the stagger assists him, and Borlée it is that comes into the straight in the lead. So Borlée, Belgium, the second of the twins, looking very strong. Rooney coming through very strongly indeed, so is Bren. So, Borlée is going to take this. Rooney being under pressure. He gets the second place, and third place was Youssef of Sudan, right on the outside. A very strong finish, 45.14. Not as quick as his brother, but he did the job, and that's all that matters. And looks as though this... I just wonder what happened to Naligo of Benin. He pulled out. He's around about the 150 to go mark. But Kevin Borlée, very, very impressive indeed. Both of the Borlée brothers from Belgium, good. Rooney, good run, is through. He's much bigger than the rest as he comes off the bend. But by this time, between two and three, that's where Borlée started to make his mark. A very, very good transition into the straightway. And look at Youssef right on the outside, coming past the world indoor champion in the final stages. Couldn't quite get through to Rooney, but he got to the third place. And that's all that matters, that he qualifies. But Borlée, elegant, very positive, eases down in the finish, and that's the way to qualify.
One man on the brink there is Brenes. I'm not quite sure whether he's done quite enough to qualify. Certainly at least two men have gone quicker in fourth place. But the Borlée twins looked good, didn't they? Even though Kevin here, who won in 45-14 from Rooney, 45-36, and Youssef 45-46, Kevin didn't need to run as fast as Jonathan, but both of them looked very impressive, running the first part of their races hard. Jonathan kicking on to the finish, Kevin easing down a little bit. Well, here are the men who'll qualify. Let's have a look. Jonathan Borlée heading that list quite clearly at 44-43. The little cues indicating those who also qualified. There's one of them, Dane Hyatt, the Jamaican champion. Also getting through outside the top three, we have Tabari Henry and Lalonde Gordon. So Brenes did just miss out, so the world indoor champion is out. So that's one of the shocks of this round, I think. And of course, the biggest sadness of all is that Lashawn Merritt was not fit enough to go through.
Oh, well, yes. Actually, there are. Bravo is another fastest loser, 45-61, yeah, right on the end.